ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 16th பாசுரம். நாயகனாய் நின்ற நந்தகோபனுடைய கோயில் காப்பானே, கொடித்தோன்றும் தோரணவாயில் காப்பானே, மணிக்கதவம் தாழ்திறவாய், ஆயர் சிறுமியரோமுக்கு அரைபறை மாயன் மணிவண்ணன் நென்னலேவாய் நேர்ந்தான், தூயோமாய் வந்தோம் துயிலழப்பாடுவான், வாயால் முன்னம் முன்னம் மாற்றாதே அம்மா நீ, நேய நிலை கதவம் நீக்கேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹவ் ஆல் அசெம்பிள் டு டூ த பாவை நோம்பு, அண்ட் நவ் தே ஆர் ப்ரொசீடிங் டுவர்ட்ஸ் த பேலஸ் ஆஃப் லார்ட் கிருஷ்ணா, பிகாஸ் தே வாண்ட் ஹிம் டு கிவ் தெம் சர்டன் திங்ஸ் ஸோ தேட் தே கேன் கம்ப்ளீட் த பாவை நோம்பு. So proceeding to the palace of Lord Krishna, they start with the fourth scene of Thiruppavai. Aandaal has made this fourth scene of Thiruppavai a very special one. In this scene, she tries to wake up the household of Krishna. And the five pasurams from 16 to 20 speak about waking up of the family members of Lord Krishna and Lord Krishna himself. So as Aandaal and her friends reach the palace of Lord Krishna, they find the gatekeeper first. The gate is closed and the gatekeeper is keeping watch. So Aandaal calls out to him, nAyaganAi nindra nandagopanudaya koyil kaappane. Koyil kaappan means the one who is guarding the temple where the Lord resides. And which temple is this guard guarding? Nandagopanudaya koyil kaappan. He is guarding the temple of Nandagopa. It seems the house of Nandagopa itself was considered a temple by the people of Gokulam. So, she says, Nandagopanudaya koyil kaappan. Koyil means temple. It also has another meaning that it is the home of Nandagopa. Home is also called as Koil, the place of refuge. So, this guard is standing at the gate of Nandagopa's house. And how is this Nandagopa? He is Nayaganai Nindra Nandagopan, says Aandaal. Nandagopa is the perfect leader, Nayakan, it seems. Because a perfect leader is the one who leads by example. And Nandagopa always led by example to the Gopas. He was a very righteous leader in the sense that he would always ensure that the right amount of milk is taken out from the cows and the dues were paid in time to the king and all that. Not only that, he was also a great leader in showing people how to be affectionate and protective about Krishna. We have seen Aandaal herself describing Nandagopa as Kurvel Kodundolilan Nandagopan. He was always ready with a sharp spear to ward off any evil against Krishna. Thus, he was leading by example. He ensured that everybody in Gokulam had this mindset of protecting Krishna always. That is why all of them had become so fond of Krishna and so protective about him that they all felt that Krishna was their own son. That kind of leadership Nandagopa had, that he could inculcate love and affection for his son in the minds of people as if he were their own son. So, this Nayakan Nandagopa is an exemplary one, and so he has kept his gatekeeper also as an exemplary one. You are keeping guard so vigilantly. It is early morning, and generally, even if guards stay up through the night, they tend to doze around in the morning times. But you are not like that. You are a leader amongst guards apparently. You are also Nayagan. Nayaganai nindra nandagopanudaya koyil kaappan. This Nayakan leader is also an adjective for this koyil kaappan guard. So you seem to be a very efficient guard. Please let us in. Koyil kaappane. Thus, speaking nicely to this gatekeeper, these girls go inside and then they reach to the door of Krishna's palace or Nandagopa's house or the temple where Krishna is. And there, they find a flag hoisted near the door. Normally, there's always a flag hoisted in temples called the Dhvajastambha. And all Vishnu temples have Garuda Dhvaja or the symbol of Garuda in their flag. So, such a Garuda Dhvaja is also present in Nandagopa's house because that is the residence of Lord Krishna. So, at that point where this flag is hoisted and the door is there, there is another guard standing. These girls talk to this guard. Kodithondrum thorana vayil kaappane. Vayil kaappan is doorkeeper. Thorana vayil kaappan is that keeper of the door where a flag is hoisted. And kodithondrum thorana vayil kaappan refers to the Garuda Dhvaja which is hoisted on top of Nandagopa's house near the door. So they call out to this guard to open the door, the one who is present near this Garuda Dhvaja. Now this person is not ready to budge as the gatekeeper had budged. Gatekeeper was called Nayakan by these girls and very nicely they elude him so that he let them in. But this man was more strict. So he wanted to know on what business these girls had come that too this early. So he asks them, why have you all come? And even before that, who are you all? He says, these girls are going to reply to that. But before that, they see the beauty of this door. And they see that it is all studded with wonderful gems and pearls. So, ignoring his question, they once again say, Manikadavam Thaltiravai, please open the latch of this beautiful pearl-laden door. Manikadavam Thaltiravai. This man stands in between the door and them and again stops them and says, please answer my question first. I asked, who are you all? Oh, you are asking about us. We are little girls of Gokulam. Ayar Sirimiyar Om. Ayar Sirimiyar refers to little cowherdesses of Gokulam. We are all little girls, Gopikas from Gokulam who have come to see Krishna. You don't get scared that we are some demon in some disguise having come to harm Krishna. We are not any demon because generally demons are all men. But this man, this guard is saying, you don't say things like that. I have seen the first person who came to harm Krishna was a demoness, not a demon. She was a female. She was Putana. So, I don't trust women either, he says. So, these girls say, you may not trust women, but you can trust girls, right? We are small girls. Sirumiyarom, they say. And we have not come on our own accord. The Lord told us yesterday, you know. He told us to come here yesterday. Arai parai mayan manivannan nennalevai nerndan. This Lord Manivannan, who is sleeping inside, Lord Krishna was known by the name Manivannan, it seems. He has told us yesterday, Nendale Vainirdan, that he would give us Arai Parai. Arai Parai refers to a drum which gives out good sound, loud sound. And such a drum is needed for our Pavai Nombu. So, Krishna had told us yesterday that you all come to my house in the morning tomorrow and I will give you all this parai. Now, parai is drum now. That is what we are going to say till the 29th pasuram. We have spoken about parai even before in the first pasuram. And now again, we are speaking about parai. Andal is speaking about parai. And here also, let us only understand that she is talking about the drum which she needs to complete her Pavai Nombu. And that drum she is going to get only from Lord Krishna. So apparently Krishna has told these girls. We did not know the story till now. But from the 16th pasuram we understand that Krishna has secretively told these girls to come and collect the parai from his palace. And so these girls are telling the guard. These girls don't talk lies. They always speak the truth. Because they want to serve the Lord with the flower of truth. Satyam Pushpam. We saw in the 5th pasuram. So they are speaking the truth. And this guard also trusts that these girls will not tell lies. So he is looking at them, but still he is not too convinced to yet open the door. So these girls start speaking further. "We have come for the Lord because he is Manivanna," they are saying. What is the meaning of this term Manivandan? Manivandan in Tamil refers to the one who is having the color of a gem called Indranila. The Lord is dark hued, so his color resembles a kind of a bluish black gem called Indranila. So he is called Manivandan in Tamil. This is one of the interpretations. Another interpretation is, the Lord is a gem by himself. He is the gem amongst gods. He is as precious as a gem. Now all these are attributes of a gem. But there is another important attribute to a gem. However precious a gem is, it can be safeguarded very easily. How much ever may it be precious, safeguarding a gem is an easy task. Why and how? Because it is small in size. It can be kept inside the fist and held tightly and be safeguarded. The Lord is also like this, it seems. He is the greatest. He is of wonderful value. He is priceless. But he can be held by us in our hearts, which is in the size of our fist. So, Manivannan is a name which tells us about the saulabhya of the Lord, or the approachability of the Lord. So the Lord is so approachable that he has let even us, Ayar Sirumiyar, little girls, little gopikas, to go and reach him. So you must not prevent us from doing so. We have all come with pure hearts, pure minds and pure actions. Tuyomai vandom. We are all pure by manovakaya, that is by thought, word and action. So we have come to just wake him up from his slumber and do our pavai nombu. Tuilalappaduvan means we have come to wake him up. You should let us inside and not prevent us from this divine experience. Vayal munnam munnam matrade ammani. Do not by your word, vayal munnam munnam matrade, by your mouth, by your word, do not prevent us from going inside. Ammani, amma here refers to somebody who has a lot of compassion. You have to be compassionate because you are guarding the Lord against evils. So being the guard of the God of the universe, you have to have his quality of being compassionate too. So do not say that you will not let us inside by your mouth. You please let us inside. We have come only because the Lord has called us and only for his sake. Listening to this plea of the girls, this Koil Kapan is moved and thus he is going to open the door. At that time, these girls see the latch of that Manikadavam, that beautiful door. And Andal says, "Neya nilai kadavam neeku." This latch and the hole are attached with neyam or affection, nesam. You remove that, you open this shackle of attachment and let us to the Lord. She has a beautiful message in this. If we let alone these shackles of attachment to this mundane world called samsara, we can open the doors and go to the Lord and reach him. So this beautiful message Andal has kept in the 16th pasuram. Not only this, she is also telling us the right way to approach the Lord when we go to a temple. Normally, when we go to any temple, we try to go to the main shrine directly. That's not the right way to do so. We should go and visit the parivara of the Lord and then go to him. That would please him more. And this is what has been told by Swami Ramanuja in his Vaikuntha Gadya, when he says, "Samasta parivaraya Srimate Narayanaya Namaha." When you go and bow down to the Lord, you bow down to him with his entire family. So if we visit all the shrines surrounding the main shrine and then go there, that is the right way to approach him. And this Andal has shown through her 16th pasuram. Once these girls are let inside, they are going to do something. Let us see what they are going to do tomorrow.